We're here today with Al Elvin, who is running for Oak Park School District. How are you today?
I'm good. How about yourself?
Can you tell us why you've decided to run for the school board?
Yes, I'll try to make a long story short. But as a parent here in Oak Park for the last 16 years, I immediately, when I moved here, was heard rave reviews about the school district. I put my two sons in the district, and one of whom needed some services from a speech and language standpoint that, and he came from a different school district, Canton Schools, and they were giving him services. We moved here and Oak Park wouldn't. And so as a parent, I was disconcerted at the time. And I, you know, thought that's what planted the seed initially. That was many years ago, it was 13 years ago. That same son who would not receive those services went on to do well and then is now in college at Oakland University. But that planted the seed. I feel like as taxpaying citizens and parents that we should not be forced to make decisions in which we have to find some sort of other method to educate our students or our children, as opposed to the one that we're in, the city in which we live, where we pay our taxes. And I was forced with that decision. I don't want that for anyone else. And so that planted the seed. I do feel like as if, you know, I can be some value added to the board though.
So in addition to some of the things that you mentioned, what do you want to work on if you're elected?
So some of the things that I care about, obviously, are making sure our students return safely due to the COVID situations. I'm very, I've been monitoring that situation very closely, as everyone probably has. And so our superintendent is doing a wonderful job. I'm in lockstep with her plan to move our kids forward. Currently, right now, I know that school has already started, so I'm in lockstep with that plan. But moving forward, what does that look like? And so I want to make sure that our staff, our teachers, our students are all safe and, you know, that we are educating in an environment that allows that. Another thing that I am concerned about is our students in terms of their college preparedness. We want to make sure that they have the opportunity to move forward from a college preparedness standpoint with ACT tests and SAT tests, AP classes, giving them every opportunity they can to advance. I know Oakland Schools does something from a technical standpoint where they teach kids to code. I think our children should be we want to make sure they're taking advantage of that. Obviously, dual learning and getting as many of our students involved in that as possible. And then for those who choose to do other things from a vocational standpoint, partnering with business, businesses or local businesses if need be, partnering with whoever needs to be involved to make sure that our students have opportunities in vocational areas. And so want to make sure we're doing that and providing career awareness, things of that nature, so they have an opportunity to see what's available to them. Not saying that some of that is not being done now, but I think there's more opportunity to partner, certainly, partnering with our parents so that we can all be on the same page in terms of the education of our youngsters. One of the main things that I've heard about is kind of that revolving door of students. Some of our students are leaving the district and so are some of the staff. So we want to provide an opportunity and a location and a place where everybody feels they can thrive and move forward. And so I do feel like providing innovative learning, additional innovative learning experiences for our kids, such as, you know, I would say for students who learn differently, like mine, making sure they have those opportunities available to them at an early age when they're diagnosed. And for those students who have shown ability to achieve at a higher rate, challenging them to the level that they're at so that they feel like they're getting that challenge and they don't need to go elsewhere. And as well as far as our education staff, making sure that we're paying them commensurate with the value that they bring to the district and to our students. So those are just some of the things I'm thinking about and some of the things that are kind of in my top of mind for me.
So can you tell us a bit about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Yes, absolutely. So, you know, early on in my career, I was a news reporter at the Oakland Press, where I actually covered the school district for the city of Pontiac here on Valley Schools and some other municipalities, including the city of Pontiac. And then I moved into the corporate world, into business. And so I've had an opportunity now to lead a team of my own. I'm in charge of a multi-million dollar budget. And so I understand finances. I understand, you know, obviously the financial statements and things of that nature that come across. As far as education goes, my bachelor's degree is in journalism, followed by a master's degree in communications with an emphasis on public relations and organizational communication from Wayne State. And then I went on to get an MBA and a Juris Doctorate, both from University of Detroit Mercy. Somewhere in my life, I spent time as a teacher. So 5.5 years in the classroom, plus an additional 2 years as a college adjunct professor at Wayne State. I have an opportunity to understand what our teachers go through. To see things from the other side. To do all the lesson plans, to deal with all of the state required documents and, curriculum planning and things of that nature, school improvement plan, all of that. So I spent time in the classroom and working outside the classroom to enhance the lives of our youngsters. And obviously, I do feel as if my background is a little bit eclectic, but at the same time, I think it meshes well for a role like this one.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in Oak Park and in the school district?
I'm new to being involved in the school district, but my track record for community service throughout South Michigan is there. I serve as the president of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated in the Detroit chapter. And we as a group have spent time just recently giving out PPE throughout Southeast Michigan part, you know, and so also we have spent time with Forgotten Harvest recently. We give away scholarships every year, a good portion of scholarships every year, at least 25 a year. So my community service isn't just relegated to the district, but it is throughout Southeast Michigan, and I've been glad to have been a part of that. And so those youngsters that we've been able to impact and help come from a multitude of school districts, not just ones like Oak Park, but Detroit, Southfield, other districts as well.
So in this race, there are a few people running for these seats. Why should the voters pick you?
As I said, I do believe from a educational business standpoint, I bring something just a tad bit different. My background is a little bit different and eclectic, but I do feel like it has prepared me well for a role like this one. I also, like I said, I spend my days dealing with boards as it is. So, and it's my responsibility, the team that works for me, it's our responsibility to manage a couple of very large boards. One is 35 members in size and one that's 17 members in size. So we have spent time doing that already. I know I lead that team. I understand how boards function. I also understand from a budgetary standpoint of how the money works, how foundation grant dollars work, which is how our districts are paid for each student. So I've spent that kind of time, done the homework. I know what it's like, and I think I'm well prepared for a role like this one. I'm not saying that others may not be, but I do feel as if my time spent in the classroom, my time spent in the business world, and some of the ideology and ideas that I'm thinking about, hopefully something that I can bring to the table here in Oak Park, that I think that's a little bit different from what other people might have in terms of their background.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
My website is Elvin4, oakpark.com. And so they can go there, they can, reach me from there. They can see all of my ideas and things of that nature for moving the district forward, or for at least helping to move the district forward, because no one person can do it alone. And so they can see it there. They can also contact me by phone or email. My email is simple, is al@elvin4oakpark.com. So al@elvin4oakpark.com. Or they can reach me by phone. So I can be reached at any one of those platforms.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to do the interview with us today.
Glad to do it. Thank you for having me.